138 in progress.
We have a problem.
Potential problem podcast.
And my carpet was like dark brown.
She's the coolest old lady.
I'd fuck her.
I just don't care.
Hey, can you give me a ride to jail or something?
Now let's get started.
Boom. 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 What's up with the sound?
Just give it a second. Give it a second.
There we go.
All right. And there we go. I don't know why it sounds that voice.
I got all the volume.
Let's go ahead and go through the intro.
Yes. All listeners out there. How's it going? Potential Problems Podcast. We'll get that out of there. That's the dog barking. And that's Alan. Alan has a dog.
Big Alan. In the house.
Looks like, here we go.
Yo, I got. I'm picking up everything, dog. I heard that.
Let's see here.
Wow. I'm loud. I'm picking up everything.
Yeah. It's very.
Can you tell? I can barely hear Johnny.
You can barely hear me.
Yeah, John. I know you don't.
The levels seem
Johnny.
To be coming through normally, so that's good.
That is good. One, two.
Anyways, why let it die? Just keep talking.
Let's do it. Fuck it. Let's do it.
Yeah, we're gonna do it. But I want to find out. Let's get to the bottom of this as well. So everybody out there listening, tell us what you hear. Tell us what's going on.
Hold on.
We're holding on.
Yeah, we're doing some makeshift stuff here. You know.
Wait a second. Now fade now. Y'all might have the power now.
Check.
Give it a second. Are we up?
I think.
Yeah.
That's that.
There we go. There we are.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, that was the problem.
Yeah.
Hear me?
All right. Your microphone wasn't plugged in.
I was.
Oh, hey, that's kind of a problem.
That's all it was. Anyways.
Potential Problems Podcast. We're here. It's Wednesday. Hello, folks. Welcome. Welcome to the Wednesday podcast. Working with professionals here.
Yeah.
Me and Alan, we're here for an hour before the show, and we forgot to plug in the mic and do a quick, simple mic check. We're too busy coming up with material. We put a lot into this show today.
Yeah, we put our blood and guts into this show.
I wouldn't go that far, but we did put a lot of... effort in
did
today's
our,
show.
Okay, if we didn't put our blood and guts, did we put our blood and Crips in?
I don't
think so.
There
you go.
No.
Yeah.
No. Top of, oh, no, don't get a shot.
Potential Problems Podcast. Today's Wednesday. I'm John. That's Alan fixing the sound
Hello.
There. Good job, Alan. We have Black Mike here. He's our third.
Hola, come on, stop.
Welcome back,
on,
Black
stop.
Mike. How you been?
I've been good. Things have been better, but, you know, I can't complain.
Are you having a good night so far, at least?
Yes, I am, man. It is.
Were you
fabulous?
Straight from work,
always.
Yeah.
Do you ever come on work?
Sometimes.
The work jerk.
It happens.
Yeah, the work jerk.
Because there's so many areas in that call center where you can just get biz.
Oh yeah, totally.
So
little crevices
areas.
Everywhere, empty cubicles.
Yeah. No, you gotta go like in
Dude,
a quiet room.
Here's something interesting. At my work, they're talking about a space consolidation thing in which we have to share a 8x6 cubicle with another person.
Ah, you gotta put me with a chick, man.
I know, but,
Then you'll find out all
sharing
her,
isn't caring when it comes to this kind of work.
Well, the thing is like you'll find all her inconsistencies. Like she can be beautiful on the outside, then you sit in a cubicle with her, and then you find out this bitch farts.
I work with old women. I work with hens.
Don't go ahead and laugh, Luis, because that you. I know me. I would clown, especially a hen that's farting. I would feel like,
oh,
wait a second,
dude, her enchilada farts are the worst.
Potlucks, right? You'd be like, nah, fuck these potlucks.
Yeah.
Quit bringing potato salad, whatever you do.
Exactly. Ranch. That's what, you know what?
Ranch dressing.
Ranch dressing.
Maybe not
me.
Carne Adubata right out. In the first thing in the morning.
You know, that's a good fucking point. The broads at the job where I work, there used to be a lot more broads there before they moved them to this other spot down the freeway. And whenever the reps would bring in lunch, because they would bring in lunch, like, hey, thanks for your business or whatever, they would bring in, like, ranch or whatever with, like, Dion's Pizza or something.
And they are blowing
bitches
it up.
Would be gobbling that shit up like it was like there was no fucking tomorrow. Yes. No, well, mostly the ranch. Like you would come in and you would like I had a late lunch, so there would be very little ranch left. Like there'd be four or five empty. And that's another thing. None of these people would put their fucking ranch bottles away. So you'd like go and you'd be real hopeful that of the fucking five open ranch bottles, maybe one of them has enough to fucking put your pizza, you know, dip your pizza in.
I know what you mean. It's almost like what's going to happen on Friday, the whole Black Friday thing, right?
Yeah.
I've been watching commercials.
Everyone's fucked who's going to participate.
Well, the thing is, it's like Walmart. They're advertising this 50-inch TV for $500. It was like $400 or some bullshit like that.
Yeah.
I'm like, but what they don't tell you is the fuckers only got four.
Mother, and they're like, a really shitty brand. It's a really shitty brand. Yeah.
You know, waiting you for got that TV. Four?
Walmart was advertising like a 55-inch
Emerson,
TV.
Right?
Yeah. But it's a brand that nobody knows about.
Emerson just means like in whatever wherever it's from.
Emerson
wherever.
is a synonym for
knockoff. Like, you know, that's well, just like fugazi.
I was going to say economy.
Yeah. Our fugate like I had this one cat, right?
Fragile.
Like you know, everyone knows I work at a call center, right?
Yeah.
So I like it sometimes when I get the brothers, right? So I got this one brother, right? He calls in. He's like, yo, what's up with this tablet? I'm like, what do you mean? He goes, y'all sold me an iPad. This shit is for Gazy. I'm like, what you mean? He goes, this shit say Samsung on this. He's like, yo, this shit was made in Korea, and I know Apple was in China. He was just going off, man. This shit was
I know,
so
it's a rip-off.
Yeah, rip-off, right? It's all the same, though. You know, Apple, Samsung, Android. You know.
It's all shit that we don't need.
I'm going to start just stocking up on Apple products. People go crazy over Apple.
They really do.
I'm waiting for that day where Muggs is like fiending, like, I'll suck your dick.
When the new iPhone came out, and instead of like a bunch of hipsters lining up, it was all Chinese people at the New York stores.
Oh, man.
Because the first thing they were doing, they were the first ones in line, no emotion towards it or anything. It was all money, money, money.
It's true.
The second they pick up like as many as they can, you see a camera guy follow them just up the street, and they sell them right then.
Oh, it's true. Like,
and then it gets shipped back over to China.
It's the hustle.
It's the same with sneaks, man. Like, sneakerheads. Yeah. Like, guys that don't even like sneakers will buy a shitload of, like, some exclusive kicks. At least sell them to dumbasses for, like, $1,000, $1,500 and some $200.
I'm telling you, if you want to test that theory out, too, Alan, just make a fake eBay post iPhone. And watch how many, like,
it'll all be emails.
Usernames
it'll
or, like,
all be emails
characters.
With, like, the spelling errors. Like, I want to buy the phone. Yeah,
phone. With an F.
You must sell me the phone, or I will not be able to feed my family.
What ESN number? I need check. Make sure I activate.
I will send you a PayPal payment.
A PayPal, yeah.
Yeah, something really weird.
I don't understand PayPal. Can someone explain this shit?
PayPal is essentially very hard to track because it's a one-time sort of URL for each user. So you can have an account with PayPal, but each payment you make is through like a different sort of code.
See, that's the problem for me. Fuck
so,
the code. I need
so
to
if you get ripped
ATM.
Off, it's very hard to get your money back.
See? Ripped off. Yeah. I need to pull cash out, though. That's what I'm saying. Like, you know what I mean?
Well, essentially, like, you're putting all your money online, right, with the PayPal account? Like, so
yeah.
If you keep it
it's
there.
All online.
Damn.
Yeah, I'm always sketchy about
you can't,
it online.
Yeah. Like that's probably why, like, a lot of my friends who, like, smoke drugs don't do PayPal. Because you can't PayPal your drug dealer, can you?
No. Probably
you, you
not.
Could, you
I mean,
cube
you could.
That, you could cube that bastard, though. Weed dealers, we already know. With the cube. Yeah. I mean, we're next level with it. So I'm sure PayPal, if they're not already.
You can use that to buy baggies.
Right.
You know?
Word up, man. Heroin addicts buying some H with the cube, man.
What's the cube? Is
the
that?
The cube's the slide. You
the
know,
slide
yeah,
for your
you
phone,
the
right?
App. Yeah, you put it on okay. your, with the Apple. That's one of the big things with the Apple that I like. I see a lot of comics taking advantage of that with, like, merch. And they're like, yeah, I have
really?
No money. There it is. Bam, man. The cube.
Yeah,
let me get
that
money.
Slide that card, baby. Yeah,
here's
no,
this shirt you
don't need
that
no cash right here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Slide
a shirt that
baby.
You'll wear once and then a letter will fall off of it and you're like, fuck, why did I buy it?
I usually use those as my spank rags.
Spank rags.
Or a shirt that you'll find at the bottom of a drawer for your next breakup. You know, just like, I remember when we went out that night and I bought this shit and I was so happy. Fucking
then from there it turns into a paper mache volcano. You just start crusting it up.
That's because when you first meet
spank
a woman,
shirt.
Yeah.
You don't see her true bitch form.
That,
You don't see her true bitch form. I think you don't see the fucking lovely.
I think you don't see the true bitch form until they're like really drunk and they're utterly pissed off about something really bad.
It's when they remotely think you're cheating. That's true.
Well, that's just anything.
True bitch form.
Like a Super Saiyan.
Exactly.
Well, that's just anything where they levels up. Yeah, it's just anything where they think you might be lying or something like that.
But what's flabbergasting to me is like I look at this chick that I just knew I loved. I'd fucking jump in front of a truck for her. I'm like, wait a second. Did you just talk about my mom?
Would you jump on a grenade for her?
At one time, you feel that, but until they...
Would you jump in front of a train for...
Because women always, they hit those pressure points on you, you know? They know all your... Because you tell them all your sensitive shit. Like, when I was 7, you know, my dad tried to jerk me off. And then one day, she'll fucking throw it at your face. That's why your daddy was touching your penis. Right. That's why your daddy was touching your punk ass. You know?
Like, my sensitive stuff is like, when I was 4, I accidentally killed a little roly-poly on the street.
I
threw a snail. Like, what?
My saddest story is I told Luis the story. Did I tell you the story when my dad left me and my dad was supposed to pick me up?
Should I have the laugh track ready?
Oh, yeah. That shit gets thrown at me all the time. That's why your punk ass dad didn't even get the call to come get you. He told me he was coming to get me for the summer. I was waiting outside for 3 days.
Yeah.
3 days I was waiting. My mom was like,
that sounds like Joe Dirt.
Oh, man. It was.
That's why dad named you Joe Dirt.
Oh, man. I was hurt that
summer. Like, didn't you get cocky with it? Like, your mom was.
Oh, yeah. My mom was trying to downplay it. Yo, that ain't nothing. He ain't coming. I'm like, shit. He told me he got the car. He rented the car. He's on his way. Watch, 3 days he gonna be here. I'm like on the curb with like suitcases, like waiting for him, right? I'm like, dude, man, you know, 6 o'clock passed. Next day came. I'm like, wait, so maybe something happened to him. So I call my grandma's house. This motherfucker answered the phone.
In Pittsburgh.
I'm like, yo, hey, what the fuck?
What happened to brotherly love?
And the thing was, he didn't even tell me he was coming. He was like, yeah, so I was going down there in El Paso. I'm like dude, we supposed to be on the fucking road, you know?
Like, oh, damn, my bad. Man,
I just played it off. I didn't act like, you know, I act like it didn't even happen. Like, I'm gonna go play some ball, man. Fuck this.
Yeah, you don't want him to stress about it.
Yeah.
At least you talked to your dad. Shit.
Yeah. So
I definitely would be stood up any day, just as long as I could have a couple little words with his ass.
You realize, like I said, I'm older than my dad. I turned 18 and became older than my dad.
Right.
You know, my dad's cool. I love my dad. But
it's always weird when that sort of like situation happens where you're like, you know, you're more mentally mature than like the person who kind of brought you in.
Yeah.
I had one of those realizations not too long ago myself. So, yeah.
No
conversation to be had there.
So what's been going on?
A few things. We got a website now.
We got
a website.
Shout out to the website.
There is a
potentialproblems.com. Well, I'm in the process of getting all the episodes up. We got like half of them up.
Nice.
And then we got, you know, bio pages.
What about t-shirts? We need some merch.
Well, we're so poor right now that the only merchandise we could probably really sell is probably the groceries out of our fridge.
I'll tell you what, talk to D-Made. Like D-Man Romero. He got a press. Yeah, he got his own press.
That works.
In-house, baby.
Yeah, in-house, man.
I need to find a good price. We also need to find a sticker guy. Like a person to sell us some stickers.
And a good design.
Oh, we got a design.
Yeah.
I got a design.
Is it Bonobo?
No, it's not Bonobo.
Okay.
No,
that's the dog?
Yeah.
I was going to ask. That's like the head of the...
She's the mascot.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah.
Yeah, she's the mascot. Okay.
She's the placeholder for the website and for the live stream.
I can't believe she's mixed with Coyote, right?
She's Coyote and Wolf.
She's our mascot and a future meal of a South Korean family. I'm sorry, North Korean. North Korean.
You ain't got to go that far. She's Panda Express.
So she was originally her her mom's mom kind of thing was a purebred German Shepherd and got fucked by a pure white wolf.
Her mama was a hoe.
And her grandmama was a hoe because she fucked a wolf to begin with.
So then the German Shepherd wolf mix
got fucked by a coyote, which birthed this little piece of shit.
It's like the word went around on her, like, hey, you want some real dog pussy?
Every outer species that they could possibly breed with are like, yo, you got to get on this.
So she's looking at me like her mom was one of those civil rights racists.
It's like, I know you're mentioning me. I'm not going to sit back there.
You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, man. Them German Shepherd. I would have hate. I mean, like, not to bring it down, but like, yeah, man. Them civil rights German Shepherd dogs. Fuck them fuckers. Sorry.
No, there's That's people in this vicious. Apartment complex who hate my dog just because she looks like a shepherd.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The brothers downstairs.
It brings back old men.
No, they got no problems. although they got problems with me apparently.
Why?
Because I don't want to
bring home some bad white chicks. That's what be going on.
No, it's because I'm going for the ones that are across the hall, just hanging out for a night, and they have a problem with it.
Yeah. Oh, because they was trying to. They was trying to get in.
Oh, because like that whole night that thing went down, where the neighbor's friend came over and knocked on the door in her underwear and was like, "Hey, I'm on a dare."
Oh, yeah, you didn't hear about that.
I'm on a dare.
You told me about it.
So one of the other things they were doing before and after, like once we got there, they kept playing the game. And one of the things was run around the courtyard of the apartment complex in your underwear. And then they made her like go all the way around the front. And that dude was outside, and he's been pretty much irritated at me ever since because he saw me sort of with the group.
He's mad because he probably threw a suggestion. He was like, I thought we was gonna go with fuck the first black guy you saw, but apparently we're not doing that, right? You know, all right, continue running.
But so like the other day, me and my sister, we were leaving my parking lot, and
slow down, wait a second, you have a sister?
Yeah.
If you would not turn she's to the dark Mike. Side, perhaps she will.
Actually, she...
How old your sister?
She's 24.
Okay.
So make but sure. It was funny. Actually, she one time, like, our dad has some problems with certain people. And one time she dated our neighbor across the street. Just to
black
piss
people.
Him off. Yeah, just to piss him off.
We're going
to
just
my
that
sister
out there.
Dated a black dude, just, our black neighbor, just to piss off my dad. He was not happy.
Oh.
We were laughing our asses off because she didn't take it seriously. She roped him into thinking it was serious.
Mm.
And then she told me about it. And I was like, just like, you can't do this.
Like, what the fuck? You like basketball now?
Is that why we had to get you a basketball hoop for Christmas? Because
kind,
that did happen that
kind
year.
Of black guy was it? Was it like a really like square black guy or like a
skateboarder
pants?
Guy?
I guess you would say he was like a professional black guy.
Okay,
so he was more on the white attitude.
He's
more on the white attitude, but he still had his ways. You know,
I tell you what, man, that those are the most dedicated brothers.
Yeah, they really are.
They are. They go hard on their shit, man. Mm-hmm. They go on 6 years of college and. Mm-hmm.
That's the real hustle, is like being able to do everything and just be like, yeah, professional.
If anything, honestly, and the thing is, him and your dad probably would have got along.
Oh, they did until that point.
And they probably had the same view about black people.
Right.
He's like, you know, he's like, Phil, you're right.
I don't know why they do that.
Yeah.
Stupid.
It's like there's this one chick like I knew in high school. She just did not want to be black, right? You know? And she used to like
was she though?
Because
if she was white and didn't want to be black, that would be really
weird. She was black as tar. I mean, I forgot the nickname we had for her. We had a nickname
tar
for
baby.
Her. Tar baby? I know. We got there. Mad and called the tar baby. Because she talked about she was a model. I was like, bitch, you a ham model?
No, for peanut butter.
Because you got some pretty ass
struck
hands.
Struck matches?
You know? Yeah, right. But yeah, she didn't admit she was black. She's
struck
like, oh,
matches. You know,
my great-great-grandmother was French, and my great-grandfather was Indian, so I don't have black in me. I'm like, bitch, you black as shit. You are black. You are the epitome of black.
Not a fan.
You make Africans mad.
Same hate. I don't like that self-hate, baby. If you black, you black. Especially if you black. You know, because you know the difference.
I'm black in the summertime. Right. I lighten up right now. Right now, I lighten up a little bit. But in the summertime, oh, forget about it, boy. I only cut my hair because motherfuckers don't know.
Yeah, I didn't have to. I didn't have to adjust the white balance on the camera as much.
Retarded, man.
I'll cut my hair just fucking.
No, we definitely
blends.
Get a little lighter in the wintertime, you know. That sun, but I'm pretty light right now. This is my light skin.
Yeah, this is as light as I get.
Mm-hmm.
And I try to soften up my voice, not to scare the white girls away. So yeah, you know.
Yeah, you don't want the winter depression affecting like how they interact.
I only use my bass like on customers at work who talk shit to me.
Yo.
Oh, I'll throw that bass in real quick. Listen, sir, all charges are valid. I don't care what you say. All right. Well, you can cancel if you want. Just like that. Like,
what do you do? Retention?
Yeah.
You do retention, Mike?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Okay.
So. I'm like, we'll cancel.
Channeling Michael Clark Duncan.
Oh, yeah. And I'll cancel every fucking line there and then give them the total and then be a dick about it. I'll be like, all right, so, sir, all your lines are canceled. Your final bill is going to be $2,136. Would you like to make a payment? Just like that. Like, whoa, what'd you do?
How do you want to start this?
Don't you hate the guys with money, though? That I mean, they just hit you right back. All righty, will that be cash or credit? Or what do you guys accept?
I thought I had one the other day when the iPhone 6 came out, right? He was like, well, I don't have an upgrade. I'm like, yeah, too bad. I'm sorry about that. We could probably get you an early upgrade, you know, pay a little bit money. upgrade. Fuck it. I'll pay him. And he said that too. Mm-hmm. He was like, fuck it. I'll pay all four of them. Four iPhone 6s.
He got pissed off and was like, I will prove to you.
I'm going to China anyway.
I never ran that much money in my life. They got it with the cash because that money, it came up to like $3,000. He was like, use the MX card on file.
To him, he's getting $6,000 as soon as, you know, he meets up with this guy down the street.
Yeah, right. Yeah, fucking Lee.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like Lee.
Real shit. No fugazi.
No fugazi.
They have to get it on the boat. Just like how I got here, I came on boat. They bring phone on boat. I get paid.
It's like weird. Like I always bring this up. I have a joke about. I always talk about like the first time I seen a Mexican, and I didn't know. I never seen a Mexican. I never even heard of a Mexican. I'm from Pittsburgh, right? Mm-hmm. And I was in El Paso. And I'm trying to add all this shit up.
It was all spud eaters up there, right?
Well, I was thinking I was like, man, what fucking breed of Chinese?
What breed of Chinese? Is this the industrial Chinese where they just work in factories all day? What is going on?
What is up with this breed? I never saw so many Chinese chicks with bangs. What the fuck? You know, and then I tried to make sense of it. I'm like, well, they
why do they look so awake?
Yo, that's funny. Yeah, racist bastard.
Now, Mexicans is cool. You can find some cool down ass Mexicans.
Not today, man. You know, one of them cholos, like one of them, like down, like, you know, vatos. Like, I went down to the Circle K and had my ID.
There's no friendly machismos.
This guy was pretty cool though. Like, you know, he had a tattoo on the head and all that, the whole nine, man. Teardrops. And
were they filled in?
So you know.
Oh,
it was serious.
Wow.
Yeah.
We did a show.
Yeah, we did some time about that one on a show. Yeah.
This guy was cool, man. Bought me a black and mild and everything. I gave him a buck.
Yeah.
He just got out of the joint. I mean, this guy
out of respect.
Those type of Mexicans trip. If you talk to one and they like any Mexican chick, they will fuck.
Yeah.
Hey, what the fuck?
But then they're always demanding respect. That's what I never understood about the whole gangster mentality. Is like you kind of demand respect, but all you're really doing is doing it through intimidation.
That accent to me is so fucking scary. Yeah, you got all of it, baby. Yeah, we good. I'm just getting in my little Jetta and going down the street. I just need some smokes, dog.
They're definitely like, you know, I think the Latinos, Hispanics in general, everybody, we're just tough kind of guys. Like, we just have that in us. Like, we just want to, you know, what's up? You know, machismo. You know?
But it doesn't work when you're smoking an e-cigarette.
They
you look
more,
silly.
They should do more Mexican history.
What's up?
School.
Passion fruit they smoke.
They spent like
my
a
battery's
week
dead.
Right, nah. On Mexican history, like when I was going to school. But it's like, man, y'all had some real OGs. Like Pancho Villa.
No, yeah, man. Totally.
Oh man, he was a G.
But nowadays it's just sad.
Oh man,
compared to everything else.
I'm telling you, man, it's like sometimes I like to compare that. You know, this is kind of fucked up, and a lot of people, the black people, hate me when I talk about this. But this is why I feel like the Mexicans, right? They was ready to ride. They had a whole fucking war. Mm-hmm. You know, Spanish. You know, they was fucking fighting. But there's no American African war. It's just like they just took us. Like we even try to like fight back, really. You know what I mean? It was like, fuck it, we just get on the boat, man. Fuck it. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
They tricked us, man. It was a trick, man. It was like, hey man, you wanna get on this little boat, a little vacation? You got a little place called the New Land or whatever the hell it was called back then. Like,
well,
come on.
It was interesting. Like, I was looking into it, like some of that, and like a lot of the time it was like different tribes would invade other tribes and sell them off to the white people.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, that's true.
And you know, it was always interesting because, like, there was a like with the Native Americans and stuff. There was always that idea of the white people gave them smallpox. But what actually happened was a couple natives ran onto one of the ships.
And gave them big pox first.
Sure they did. They ran onto some of the ships and stole some blankets that they didn't know were infected with people's smallpox.
Oh yeah, I remember.
And yeah, so yeah, it's
the real definition of a blanket party, right?
Yeah.
Sorry.
So the cold Indian brought the Native American.
But even they fought back, right?
Yeah, man. They were throwing tomahawks and shit. I mean, they tried.
Yeah, they definitely were.
I heard they stole those blankets so they could sit on them at an Ozfest.
We have to get here early.
That's a horrible island.
You're the one who implied the joke. Fuck off. <Right. laughs>
Like John Redcorn was a pimp though, right?
Oh yeah.
John Redcorn slaying coochie.
Yeah, he was.
John Redcorn.
I just came to give massage to the wife.
Fix the pipes.
Like, I was watching the episode. I came here for a rub
and tug.
I was watching the episode, and I've seen this episode 1,000 times, but I never noticed this part, and it made me laugh so hard, right? So Dell's leaving for work, right? And John Redcorn's coming up, and his wife is asleep. John Redcorn had a fucking key.
He had a fucking key?
He had a key. He said, "Hey, Dell, how's it going? Just go ahead and make massage." You know? He has a key.
That's fucking awesome.
Was it even a working key?
It worked.
Oh, okay. I thought it would be like one of those things where you go in with a key hoping that like they wouldn't realize it's not the right shape.
But like if you watch the show, you would know, like, obviously that was probably Dell's idea. Yeah.
I always thought, like, you know, like John Redcorn was probably hitting like Luann. I don't know because Luann was a little promiscuous, man. It is in here. That's like the backstory. Something happened.
I know that brother that worked at the propane shop. Right. He had to be digging it.
Was it the comedian dude?
Yeah. Phil Lamar, right?
Something like that. Yeah, I forgot. Yeah. Somebody was smashing.
Yeah, he had to be.
Luann was a hot piece. Yeah, I would have done that.
Even the real life Luann, boy.
Brittany Murphy.
Brittany Murphy, yeah.
She dead, isn't she?
Yeah.
She's really hot right now because she's so skinny.
No, she's cold.
That's a cold piece.
Yeah, she was pretty bad. Rolling with the homies.
Are you more of a clueless Brittany Murphy or
I like the bong water Brittany Murphy.
Nah, I was all that about cool Stacey Dash.
It was a Jack Black movie.
I like 8 Mile Brittany Murphy.
Oh yes.
Definitely like 8 Mile Brittany Murphy. She looked greasy and just
sweaty. Who wouldn't like a woman who spits into her hand as lubrication for sex?
Yes. Oh my God.
How would you guys love that?
I would have been on a knee after that.
I would have auditioned.
Marrying you.
I would have took it in the middle of that fucking plant and showed everybody how I get down.
Hey, you can't jackhammer in here.
Shit. Give an old black man thing. You ever heard that? Black man? Shit.
My man from The Wire.
Yeah.
Shit.
He had the best shit in the game, man.
And that motherfucker's like his signature, because I see him in another movie. He did the same thing. Shit.
Great callback. That guy's getting paid.
Yeah,
typecasting is what it is. It's like it's like how Rob Schneider and Adam Sandler always go in each other's movies doing that thing. Where it's like, you can do it! Cut his freaking head off! From Little Nicky.
It's a nice check for that shit.
I started in Waterboy, no?
I think Waterboy was even like a little later.
I think it was
Saturday Night Live first, and then he started getting movie deals once they realized he could do characters.
Oh, yeah. He was funny on Saturday Night Live.
It was funny. Earlier, I was meeting up with John over at Five Star to get, like, you know, food and whatnot.
Don't invite us. What the fuck?
It was 5 o'clock. But, like, I was on my way over there, and I heard on one of the rock stations, they're like, this is a Thanksgiving song. And then you just hear, going over here to eat some cranberries. Why did the Mets trade Donald Strawberry? And I was like, oh, fuck, it's Adam Sandler.
No doubt, man.
Dale Strawberry.
I didn't even realize that I didn't realize that a rock station had Adam Sandler's, you know, guitar, Jew music, loaded up.
Songs, I got Lunch Lady Land chopped and screwed in my car.
Lunch Lady Land?
Hell yeah, baby.
Chopped and screwed.
Word up.
How's some more sloppy Joes?
I love that song.
I know how you like them extra sloppy.
Right. You ever listen to Stan and Judy's Kid?
No.
Fucking hilarious. He has this skit about his uncle, and they all go fishing with the uncle, right? And the uncle, his phrase is, give it a little bit of reverse action. Basically, he's like, have you seen, what's the, that one movie when he fucked the teacher?
That's Billy Madison.
No. He fucked the teacher and when he was a kid and then grew up.
Oh, what is that?
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, with the dude, the other
Vanilla
guy from
Ice
Saturday Night Live.
It.
And,
yeah.
Andy Samberg. I don't remember what it's called. I know which one you're talking about.
But that character,
Someone
he plays
us.
That character as an old guy on the CD. And he talks about like, give it a little bit of reverse action. Like, he's in a boat, and he eventually runs over everyone in the boat. Uh-huh. You know, they over-exaggerate. My fucking leg is gone. Yeah. Oh, my God. Now it's crawling, like, crawling into my chest. You got to listen to it. It's the funniest shit ever. Out there, people listening. Stan and Judy's Kid. Very underrated Adam Sandler album.
What is it?
Stan and Judy's
Stan
Kid.
Stan and Judy's Kids?
I just said album. I sound old.
Oh, but that's CD. Just... that's
but
the
it
bit.
Is. That's what but it
yeah,
was at
no,
the time.
Album. Yeah, I'd still call them albums.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, comedy album.
Like in 20 years, you know how old we're going to sound when we say albums?
I'm going to sound 44, 20, well, 42 saying it.
They're starting to bring the album back.
They're going
to
they
be are. Bringing Dude, the album back. Sales have had like a lot more actual sales than most
better.
MP3s.
I think they sound better.
Yeah.
Me personally, but
no, I like MP3, the digital format. It has all the built-in.
I like hearing that.
It's got all the clean tone,
I like the scratch, right? That good authentic. He's talking about the album actually.
Like, yeah. I understand the nostalgia part of like listening to vinyl, but
it probably sucks to your ears.
No, it doesn't suck. It doesn't suck. I grew up in a house where they would listen to vinyl all the time, Grateful Dead and
The
Doors and shit like that. Like I was growing up in a classic rock family. Mm. They got pissed off when I was watching Who Let the Dogs Out on Disney Channel.
Oh, I know your dad.
My sister ratted me out for watching Who Let the Dogs Out on Disney.
I can't date black people. He can't watch Who Let the Dogs Out.
I was in second grade, but that was much earlier.
Fucking old as shit.
Yep,
wait a second,
yep.
You couldn't have been in second grade.
I
when
was
that
in
came
second
out.
Grade
because I was fucking like 18 when that came out.
Well, what year was it?
Like 97, 98.
Yep.
No.
Let the dogs out.
Yep. I was 7. That would make me second grade.
Jesus, I was 18.
In the third grade, he got his first Klansman uniform.
Ah. Courtesy of my dad.
I noticed your I am Darren Wilson T-shirt hanging. That's
what
I am Darren. Yeah,
he's now snapping.
I get you.
That was actually one of the things we were like, we didn't want to spend too much time on it because like we obviously you could go round and around and like there's so many
that's
different
some funny angles
to it.
There,
however, right? Did you see the video of the car plowing through a group of protesters?
I saw that.
No,
and they like and what really killed me was the fact that she stopped and then gave him a chance to destroy her vehicle.
Yeah,
and
they're just sitting there punching his car.
No, it was a guy. Yeah, man, like what? I would have just kept going. Back
he was. Yeah. I heard
did
he was.
You see Rodney Denny videos.
Mm-mm.
Don't stop.
Yeah,
I'm
never
not stopping,
stop.
Man. Ooh. Never. I'm Holly Berry.
I heard it was just. It wasn't like he didn't drive into the crowd of people on purpose. I heard it was just an Asian person driving. He couldn't yeah, stay off the fucking sidewalk.
Why are there so
I
many people here on this road?
I'm a U-turn.
I have to get to my Chinese food business so you don't burn it down.
I'm a U-turn. I know how you are.
I take picture with my new phone.
I have iPhone.
One of the things that...
one that I did not sell to China.
I make it. I make iPhone with Chinese food ingredients.
I sneak one out in pocket at factory.
Is it a menace to society where that Chinese dude tells him,
oh, yeah.
I black like you. I black like you. Is that what he's
like? No, you.
I feel sorry
how
for your mother.
How high?
Is it how high
that's
when he's
how
like,
high.
Oh, yeah,
oh, yeah,
right.
Yeah. We are brothers.
And he starts trying to get dress all gangster yeah. And get some street cred.
Boo. Boo-foo, buy us. Fuck you.
I'd rock a boo-foo hoodie. I mean, shit.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that'd be dope.
Oh, hell yeah. Mm-hmm. I'll play it off so smooth. Mm-hmm. Shit, I'll bring back cross colors. Don't fuck with me.
I don't know about the cross colors.
That's actually, that movie's the first time I heard Rammstein, and I was hooked ever since.
Duhas.
Like, when he was waking him up to that song with the blunt, I was like, yeah. Oh, my God, that song is perfect.
Definitely.
Duhas.
Like, and then I joined a German class in my high school years and learned a little bit about that, in which I actually got a couple CDs.
That reminds me of the, like, when I turned 21, I was here in Albuquerque, right? So, during that time, it was like
me too.
Raves.
Raves are big out here.
Raves are real huge. So
they're still pretty big. Yeah,
I'm coming from Pittsburgh,
and they always had weird names like Cosmic Placenta or Universal Afterbirth
or Cosby Pill.
Yeah, like
Cosby Pill.
My boy's going to Cosby Pill tonight.
Don't tell Camille.
My boys are from Florida. Can you imagine a cat from Florida walking into a rave?
Oh, shit.
Oh, man. It's like the darkest weather.
All it is a different beat. Like, from Florida, you're walking into a party where it's like...
Well, the thing is, the glow sticks threw me off. The glow sticks
and
threw
the rave, it's just like...
I love it. loved it. I loved it.
Oh, man. That shit fucked with me because I was drunk and high and all these glow sticks.
Exactly.
Going.
You weren't on the right thing.
I wasn't ready. I wasn't ready for it.
I had fun my first experience raving, man.
It was
dope.
Fun,
they had it by the old strip club by the railroad on 2nd and something.
No, the one I went to
was right here. It was right down by the old Ice House or whatever that old strip club was.
I just went to the Ice House.
they gave me, what was it, a light show, man. That's the thing with those laser beam or whatever the hell those things. Some guy walks up to me. He sees I'm on the floor just tripping balls. Right? He's like, you want a light show? I was like, yeah. This dude pulls out like 5 glow sticks and just starts going ham.
Yeah.
Just starts doing the whole ADD shit. It's like, what are you doing?
Like on
dopest shit ever.
Like in the Chappelle show. Remember that?
Which one?
When they were doing a car commercial. They were making fun of that car commercial. And that chick was in there dancing. He's like, what the fuck are you doing?
There was one time for my 18th birthday party. I had a party at my mom's house. And we had one of my sister's friends living with us, who at the time was like, he had just turned 20 or something, or 21. And so he was like the oldest person at the party of friends that I invited there. And two of my friends show up like on some combination of prescription pills. And they're all talking about raves and stuff. And my roommate, who just moved into there at the time, was kind of into that thing, like the whole rave scene. And he offered to give them a light show in one of the rooms. But he did it as an excuse to punch them.
Yeah.
What?
Too close.
Yeah, he did.
Donkey
he did
punch?
No, he did it as an
excuse.
You're
so, like, face. You get right in their
like,
face with it.
And he had like these little jelly-style rings with lights on them all over his fingers and shit. So he was doing it all.
He was like Mandarin.
And like he would do this move where he starts moving it around and they're really entranced by it. And he would sneak in a punch real quick.
And how long
was
did
like,
they
why?
Sit there?
It was a good 10-minute light show.
Holy shit.
And because they were all fucked up, they didn't feel it.
Oh, man.
That's funny.
Yeah. He's See? Like, what? But his whole point was, what the fuck are you doing showing up to an 18-year-old's birthday party all fucked up on pills?
I used to hate that shit in high school. Man, it's like you always see them motherfuckers that graduated 3 years ago. I used to get
and
mad
they're doing
the
duster.
Yeah, just try to steal the hose.
Air duster.
Yeah. You can't come here and steal the hose.
I was at a party one time where people were doing air duster. And it was like a house rave style party where there was like a DJ. And there was like this Mexican dude, like a fat guy, just sitting in the corner, sitting down on the ground with like a bandana around a spray can of like compressed air.
Goodness.
Holding it upside down, just going.
See, like when I was in middle school, right?
A little bit of whipping action back
then. It was
then.
Called, they called it spook.
Like he was doing long hits.
What was it called?
Spook.
That's what they called the. Because
it's scary.
But what they did was they sniffed like white out and all toxic. They just.
Paint.
It's like this one dude, he's like, you want some spook, bro? I'm like, fuck no, dude.
I'm spooked enough. Dude.
Yeah, I smoke weed, dude.
Like, I did the whipping. I mean, who hasn't tried the
whipping? Well, the whipping,
yeah. Whipping with the balloon. No, that's just, I mean,
but
it's nothing.
Like, the way my thinking is.
That's how the Beastie Boys do it.
Like, if you
it's
can
not
get
my
high
not my
for
thing.
169, how come everybody ain't doing it?
Right, it's so great.
Yeah. You know, why is everyone paying $20 for crack?
Essentially, you just see this.
Why are more people smoking weed than anything?
It's like, and like my hey, that looks
yeah,
like
we got the
King.
We got the video here. Actually,
that's
where
that whole tangent
so,
sort of
yeah,
led
so,
from was the fact that somebody was plowing through a crowd
of
protesters.
That was Rodney King.
It kind
of
looks like the Watt thing, the Watts thing.
Yeah, we have footage of Rodney King, but it's footage from the swimming pool, so it's not that exciting.
Did they riot?
Get it? Because he died in it. Mm-hmm.
They didn't riot in Ferguson, right? They didn't riot, right?
They oh my god, there was rioting and looting. That's still happening. They burned down 27 local businesses because we all know those ones are more expensive on their prices. You got to keep the cheaper stores up.
So when did this happen, Alan?
I think 2 days ago, maybe.
And this guy
just 2 days ago.
Did you hear any of the backstory on this? Did this
none.
Guy? Okay, so let's
none. All I know is that like there was a you know big group of protesters and somebody needed to get their car through there and they weren't getting out of the way.
Mm-hmm. I gotta get to Walmart.
Walmart. What is going on with this?
It's just some Mexicans that can't drive. So you could say Mexicans or Asians. I've driven on the west side before.
There we go.
There it is. There you go. And look, the person gets hit.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, he drives over
the
them.
Car?
And then he stopped, and then everyone just starts getting on his car.
That's game time.
Jesus.
That's game
no,
time.
You can't be.
Fuck.
He said, you know what? I just bought this Subaru.
Yeah, right?
I'm going to.
I wouldn't doubt it. I wouldn't doubt it if we still get a copyright strike. We got a copyright strike for that video that you were in. Yeah.
Who got at you? What happened?
YouTube did, and then I disputed it, which it takes it to the person whose video that is, and they still had a problem.
You talking about the Kool-Aid? No way.
Yeah.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Shoplift, because it's my boy Shoplift. I'll talk to them about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's weird.
Because I'm going to actually resubmit that. We had two other ones.
No, yeah, resubmit
one,
it, man.
Yeah,
we'll make sure to get that
should,
on there.
They should probably want it.
Yeah, yeah, because that was unfair, because he was in the video.
Right, right.
With the happy face.
Gotcha. I tell you what.
My voice was there.
We could do any Tupac video. That was me. That was me.
Yeah, those are my dudes at Shoplift. I'll chop it up with them. I'm pretty sure any pub is good pub.
Yeah, Shoplift.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. What's going on, Chris and Andrew? Fuck.
They can go ahead and isolate the part where we're talking about it because it was so hilarious.
And John.
And now we'll get more viewers.
Johnny. We need a segment. You got to talk for 5 minutes straight.
I have to.
I've done it before. We did it last week.
I heard. What's going on, Johnny? Quiet, man. What's going on?
Oh, no, no. I was. We're just. You guys are doing a great job. We're just moving along, man.
John is the biggest, one of the biggest pimps in Albuquerque.
Is he?
Oh, no.
Let's hear about this.
That's, you know, the quickest way to shut down a pimp
when we first
is to start advertising, my man.
When we first started the podcast, he suggested doing a bit called Uncle John's Bang Stories.
I did. I remember that. Though.
Yes.
Why have we not done that? That
would be because of the name.
Yeah.
That'd be hilarious. You should like get because
you told the story about when you were banging the chick whose ex-husband. Yeah, you were banging the broad whose ex-husband just showed up, and then you were in the bathroom, and a knife got stuck through the door.
Yeah, that was interesting.
Like inches away from your muscles.
From my monkey muscles. Yeah, you said I had monkey muscles. Is
okay,
that
look at
said?
Him. Look
you
at him from the side. Does he not look like a bleached version of Caesar from Planet of the Apes?
If you guys could only see this right now. Hilarious.
They can.
He does. He knows. Oh, no, you can't see this right now? Yes, definitely.
No!
No! No!
So
this is essentially every response from a chick that, you know, comes over here for the show.
Be that as it may.
That would be funny. You should do that job. And like play some like smooth, like some shit that Billy D. Williams would play.
Did it be Williams?
Like some smooth like Isley Brothers or something.
Uh-huh.
And he just talking stories.
Mm-hmm.
Show the broad, right?
See, but I'd have to be a little bit uncool about it. Instead of playing the Isley Brothers, I'd play Rod Stewart, this old heart of mine. You know, the cheesy 80s version. But I love it, man. That was like before Ron Isley was terrorizing fucking
R. Kelly's ass. He was beating R. Kelly up every other video. So
oh,
yeah, well, he whooping that ass.
Oof, Ron Isley fucking aged horribly, though.
Yeah,
holy shit.
I'm living in a closet.
Get out my closet.
Will I come out the closet? Shut up.
What do you think about that rumor? That
I met R. Kelly once.
What rumor? The pee rumor?
He peed on you?
Well, that's not a rumor.
Well, he didn't pee on me, but I met him in a sauna at Define Fitness just down the street. 100% true. I was I just got off of my swim team practice. I went to the gym afterwards to finish the
workout.
Sounds
like a gay porno already.
Shut the fuck up.
You met just got off from swim team practice.
Well,
and
I was in his age demographic. I'll tell you that.
Have my anus waxed.
I was 17. I was in his age demographic.
Oh.
So I'm at the gym. I just finished up my second swimming workout. And
regular
I'm sitting,
Michael Phelps.
I go into the Michael Phelps because I get high right after. I get it. So
questionables.
I go into the sauna. Into the dry sauna, and then one dude comes walking in, like a white guy, and he's like, dude, I think there's fucking R. Kelly here. And then, four big bodyguards, all in tracksuits, walk up with R. Kelly between them, and he's carrying a little ice chest. He walks into the sauna, and first thing he does is sit next to the hot stones and everything, and open up a bottle of water and just.
Wow.
Which you're not supposed to do in a hot sauna because the rocks could explode.
That's the Pied Piper. What are you going to tell him? That's R. Kelly, baby.
Kells. He'll pee on those stones.
Yeah, I wanted to be peeing in the pool. Did he pee in the pool?
Yeah. He didn't go in the pool. He was just in the sauna. Then I left like about 10-15 minutes after because you can only take so much steam. And then I went into the parking lot. And sure enough, big-ass tour bus. So...
Dan, R. Kelly's tour.
I learned something today. So sauna rocks can explode if you throw some water on it.
Yep, because they're so super heated and there's no moisture in that specific room, as opposed to the steam sauna where they just pump steam into the room.
Right.
So he was in the wrong room.
Yeah. fucking up, Kels.
Yeah.
Kels.
He's probably practicing. See, if I pee on her like this.
if she's this hot and I pee on her, the water will just turn into steam.
I wonder if her face will blow up.
This is a hypothesis on my part. He just starts pouring water.
If I piss on a bitch on a hot day, will her face explode? Like, I gotta find these out.
Because there's no air conditioning outside.
You know what?
There's no hotter place than Albuquerque in the summertime.
That is a perfect transition into a story that I told Al and I wanted to bring up, which was a story that's very near and dear to me. Story that, now when it comes to voting, a lot of people talk.
Scott Stubb?
No, no. We'll get to that one. But when it comes to voting, a lot of people, like I used to say it a lot too. I used to say it doesn't matter, that my vote would be canceled out, that it was just not worth doing. But in the recent months, I've changed my mind. And I'll tell you why. It's not going to be a long-winded story, but when I tell you why, you might even change your mind. You guys follow me?
Sure,
you,
like, I follow.
Your right. mind and just all right. So basically, the AVN, the 2015 AVN Awards are coming up, and it's the adult videos.
Oh, Jada Stevens.
Yes, and it's very important
talk
that
about
you
how
should
she's
vote.
Ignoring you.
You
Kurt
should
Fletcher
vote.
Wrote jokes for one of those, didn't he?
Kurt did write jokes for one of the porn awards.
Hello.
I don't know if it was this one, anyway, back to the importance of voting. Voting is a very important thing. You can impact your community. You can impact the life of
the local hot
a young
chicks.
Lady. You can impact the overall search number or number of hits she gets on her website, you know, mm-hmm. based on, you know, how much
you
vote.
Come on, be honest. Pornhub is where it's at just because that's where all the people go for the free shit. That's where all the videos get viewed.
They actually rank the porn stars there.
Yeah, they do.
On Pornhub?
Yeah.
Yeah, they rank them.
I'm in and out, man. I'm not trying to linger.
Yeah, see, if you go to a certain video that has a prominent star in it, just under the description, it'll say the name of the person. If you click on that, it'll tell you their rank and all the videos they're in.
You guys know any of the rankings? Like anybody like?
No.
Rankings?
Well,
I know interracial BBC.
I know the Asian broad, Annie Cruz is like 36 or something like that because she does both anal and squirting. Mm. Apparently, that's nice. Like some of the main criteria to be
see,
number one.
I can't
one.
Deal with the squirters, man.
It's a little rough.
Last time at her house.
I like it if it's the real squirt.
I don't
pee on me.
No,
you know how hard it is? Okay, the equivalent of being like faking a squirt with like just peeing is as hard as it is to pee with a boner.
Thank you.
That is difficult.
I don't mind the squirt if we're at her place, but these are my couches.
Well, here are some...
You ever try to... I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, go for it.
No, because you just brought up a really good thing that bothers me. Like, peeing with a boner? That's painful.
That's impossible.
But it's good. It makes you last longer because you're working your Kegels.
Oh, okay.
You're working your male Kegels. If you're able to cut the stream, you're going to last longer.
That's where I get real selfish because it doesn't feel as good as if I peed first and then bust that nut. I'm 35, so I ain't got time to be wasting.
Exactly. You don't have time.
Like, bitch, we going to pause this for a second. I'll be back.
Like, you know, as soon as, you know, you get due with the dew and you got your, you know, semi on and you go pee and you got to wait a little. If you try to rush with that first pee, it hurts. Like, you know, you got.
That's why they got a mouth.
I'm not messing with none of the girls you fuck with. None of them.
So here are some of the things that you may want to consider voting for. All
right.
Best gape of the year.
Close. We'll get to that one. The first one up is that I want to highlight is the best all girl release. One of them is Dirty Panties 2.
Hold on, let me
what? Said dirty Panties?
Dirty Panties.
Dirty Panties 2.
Panties IES?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
Let's
Part
see
two.
Here. Another of the films I'd like to highlight for your vote is Hustler's Girl on Girl Milk.
Okay.
That's
okay,
a good
right,
one.
Okay. Okay.
Sounds like pregnant bitches, but okay. Mm-hmm.
Another one called Latin Lust.
Okay, I got
Latin. I've
seen that one.
People at this table would probably, you know, enjoy that very much.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
There's also Lexi Bell Loves Girls. Are you guys familiar with Lexi Bell?
I'm familiar with Lexi Bell.
She's pretty good looking.
Okay.
Perverted Lesbian Panty Sniffers is the next film that's up.
A touching film.
That sounds kind of butch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's see here. There's also Women Seeking Women, which sounds like that's
a Craigslist ad.
Yeah. The distributor on that is Girlfriends Films. So that they seem to be pretty. There's one other category that I thought was pretty interesting. It was actually probably the most titillating, if you will. The best amateur release. We like amateurs, right?
Absolutely.
Amateurs are good.
Like, sorry, I missed hard. Something. I had to go pee with a boner.
they try hard.
So one of them from the best amateur release category is... Pure Amateur Teens 22.
Yes.
Apparently there are 21 yes. other episodes. So.
Like you're in school, take the test. Yes.
Real Swingers Kentucky. Yes. How do you guys feel about swingers?
Not from Kentucky.
Yeah. Not from Kentucky.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, it doesn't count as swinging if it's at the family reunion.
You gotta have teeth. I ain't fucking with no bitch without no teeth.
Yeah.
Let's see here. Anal first timers.
Anal first timers?
Yes.
That's something I could get behind.
I don't know if I want an amateur doing anal.
Thank
though,
you. It seems really painful and messy.
Well, no, the thing is, you may not have that anal etiquette. Like, you got to wash that shit
out.
Right,
right, right, right.
Well, not only
wash it out, wash it in.
But my friend Maria once told me, because she took it in the butt sometimes, but she told me.
Shout out to Maria.
Yeah, shout out to Maria.
You're a trooper.
Rest in peace. Had nothing to do with taking it in the butt.
But
she loved for me to talk to people about her taking it in the butt. She was like, yeah, share it with people. Make sure you share my stories. Because she wanted people to be edumacated. Mm-hmm. And so she used to tell me that she would have to go on an anal diet for like 24 hours.
Just to be able to clear out real quick, right?
So it's not like a fucking a porno where you see some guy spit on this girl's anus.
Yeah, you got to have...
And then just
stick it
in.
Your chick has to be able to have the right diet to create her own lube for that time.
Yeah. I don't know about that.
I don't know.
But yeah, I would figure like that's something you just don't jump into, man.
Yeah, she ate like a chili dog for about 20 hours ago. I don't know.
Like, what is anal etiquette? Like if you
wash it out.
What I'm saying, like during if you
just
fucking,
don't shit on me.
Like if she farts, do you keep going?
Absolutely. Yes, you do, because that's just the internal vacuum breaking from you pushing air into her ass.
What if it's one?
The seal's been broken.
The seal has been broken. It's like when you open
Mike.
It's like
talking about the pressure.
It's like when you open a jar of salsa and you have to hit the bottom of it to get the air to the other side.
I'm talking about a real fart, not a pressure fart, because you get them pussy farts too. But
a real fart, that's just fine, because you know,
really,
maybe your dick was getting cold.
What if it hit you in the face?
Maybe your dick was getting cold. I don't know.
I'm like
you need a little warmth.
So you would keep going.
I would keep going.
You would keep going.
Yeah, absolutely. Because you're already in that mode where it doesn't fucking matter. You're in her ass.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're in the thing that releases turtles on like a daily basis.
I know that. But
you're just getting a little wind.
But that won't that be your memory of that particular like fucking anal act?
No.
You know,
it's like, maybe if she farts while I'm in her. Maybe if she farts while I'm in her, the air pressure will make my dick a little bigger. I don't know. You have to look at any upsides. You're fucking her ass. What is the best case scenario you can hope for? That there's no smell. Fucking.
I don't mind.
You don't
smell.
Have to.
It smells fine, but I'm just talking. Just the act of farting.
You're being
like,
picky. As far as I'm saying,
you're okay with
the smell, but you're not okay with farts,
which has
a smell.
This is what I'm upset with
Mike.
Is it the sound or the smell for you?
Oh my God, Mike!
It's if she plays it off like it didn't happen. Like, bitch, the dick is in your ass.
She
I
wants to keep getting fucked. Exactly, she wants to keep getting fucked.
That is a trooper, like my man said. Cause see, what you gonna do at that point? You gonna call her out or keep going?
Well, my nut's more important.
Exactly.
So
she's on board.
What is your argument?
Like,
what is your argument? Because it's not very valid right now.
It would be like this. So, like, let's say, and we're talking amateurs. Mm-hmm. So she farts, right? And she stops and looks at you, and you look at Dan in the eye, and now it's a moment.
You take a deep breath and you go, delicious.
No, you get closer.
Delicious, baby.
You get closer, you pucker up, and then you just breathe deep.
Is it delicious?
Yes, I mean,
savor it.
Absolutely
delicious. Mm-hmm.
Like, in my thought in that moment, I'm like, let's just go back to.
Yeah, you give her that little, like, you know, that you give her that, like, hey, it's okay. You give her a little.
Yeah.
Little head exactly. Nod.
No,
why
back,
end a good thing?
I get back into it when it's ass to mouth. No, that just wakes everything back up. But like when she farts and like if she plays it off, I'm cool. But if she farts and like looks at me and sees that I notice, I'm like, yeah, I noticed.
It's cool.
My dick just got hot.
Yeah, I noticed. What does it matter?
My whole dick just got hot.
That's okay.
Out of nowhere, you know?
Problem? you don't want to feel like you're fucking a cadaver. Fuck.
Yeah, I always imagine Clarence Carter, though.
Mikey told me, Mikey Long told me this story about this girl.
Shout out to Mikey Long.
Yeah, Mikey Long. I don't know if you're out there listening, but about this girl who he had an anal experience with. And his tip, he had a bit like this for a while. And his tip about that was to make sure that if you guys are going to use some anal lubricant, here's the thing, guys, is what you have to do is make sure that it's not something that is going to cause the other person to have some sort of anal release.
Oh, yeah. Nothing that'll ease the flow.
Well, it was like, I guess.
You got to make sure they did it before.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, and it was after a drunken night. They came home at night, and she wanted to do it. So she was like, there's some lotion on the nightstand. So he did. And they were in the middle of it, and boom, things happened, and she like jumped off of him real quick and like gathered the covers around him and was like, "You should go," and he awkwardly left.
Oh, yeah. That bitch, go hop your ass in the shower.
And it was but he swore up and down, and it was true. And if you know anything about Mikey Long, you know that sometimes he bullshitted, but in those certain instances, you know he was telling the fucking truth.
I believe that one.
So, that was pretty funny. One of those Mikey Long.
I don't do too much with the butt play, but
Now, okay, so let's just go ahead.
It's few and far between.
Yeah, few and far between.
So AVN Awards, folks. You need to go out and
vote. We're not voting for Jada. Why are you supporting Jada Stevens so much? I assume she was the star of all of those films.
No.
She follows you on Twitter, right?
I like Pinky.
She does follow me.
And the brain.
I like Pinky. Pinky's my favorite, and still to this day. I like her because of, you know why I like Pinky? Because she really sells it. Like, she's sucking dick. And she does that noise, like, glock, glock, glock.
There's another bitch that fucks with Pinky.
Right there, I'll be done.
Her name's America.
Of course. Never heard of him.
America. Look up America.
America?
America!
It's like, you seen other guys? Remember? The other guys? Uh-huh. And he punches the gas. He's like, America! I think he fucked her.
Oh, from, yeah.
I like Pinky, man. She has the little midget arms.
I tell you the one, they're like T-Rex.
Yeah, she's bad. She bought the tan
she
line.
Is bad.
Line ass thing. That was her, man.
She's thick, but she's very fat.
Right. She's like, she's bad. I like Pinky.
I tell you, one of my favorites is, what's her fucking name?
Jada Fox.
Nah, not Jada Fox.
Yeah. Just to interject real quick.
Go ahead.
There's also a best comedy category.
Yeah, I look at that one frequently just best to see if comedy. There's anything
so
new.
Like
there was one time a video of where a dude like was a pizza delivery guy and he fucked the chick like with the pizza as a barrier.
Oh, that's so fucking.
So he stuck his dick through the pizza,
like a pizza glory hole.
Yeah,
that's exactly what it was. Dope.
When did they start
pizza
making?
Uh-huh.
There was also an In Search of Sasquatch like, style video.
Was so like that one movie you're talking
it
about.
It was a guy in a Sasquatch suit.
I saw that one.
What is like comedy themed porns or comedy scenes?
Here, watch.
Or bloopers and shit.
I'll
like
read
that.
Through their names real quick. Bikini babes are shark bait. Landlord. the long hard ride. The masterpiece. Mysterious ways. Odd jobs. Owner gets clipped. Porno pirates on the Pacific.
I wonder what that's a parody of.
The pornographer. Proud parents.
Okay, enough with the peas.
The real thing. Southern hospitality, squatter, switch, and vampire cheerleaders. Which, that actually, I'm going to check that one out at some point, I think. So vote.
Okay.
Vote.
There's a lot of sign language going on right now. I can't tell what it is.
Taking care of some back room dealings.
But,
definitely support the AVN Awards and vote right now.
Yeah, you guys. So
despite all of John's restraining orders that were placed on him by Jada Stevens,
she still follows me on Twitter.
No doubt.
Yeah, to make sure that you're not saying, "Hey, I'm in California" or something.
She has to check. Where's John? I'm not going there.
Did you have a story you wanted to kick out there?
Bears.
Bears. What happened with bears?
No, not the bears.
Just bear.
An actual bear.
Have you guys ever seen a bear in real life?
At the zoo.
Yeah, I went like to this bar from, once. This guy bite me not a couple of drinks, and after that,
in
I,
the
know,
wild, it's pretty
went
terrifying.
To his apartment.
Hell yeah, I'm sure,
didn't
man.
Didn't want to say what happened after that.
What happened? What's up with the bear?
So, in there, a lot of places, there's a big problem with bears, and that like there's too many bears for the territory, kind of thing.
Bears.
So there's not enough food for them to all sort of eat equally.
Right.
And, for all the what?
Bears.
Bears.
We're talking about bears, right? Okay.
No, I'm sorry. Go. Go.
So I we're talking football, anything. Right?
Not enough food anything. For the bears, so they're having to go into like cities and stuff to try to like that happens here quite a bit. So there's
open these, season.
Yeah, there's these kids in New Jersey, and they were like hiking like in a partly forested area. They see a black bear. They see a black bear, and they start taking pictures of it. What is your first and like actual instinct when you see a fucking bear? Run or fucking.
I'm fucking
confront
gone.
It.
I'm fucking gone.
Don't take pictures. This isn't a fuck. This is no time for a world star video.
Do you know how far away he was from them?
About 100 feet.
Doesn't okay. matter. That bear
they
started
saying, yeah, yeah that's quick. Enough time. Bears can run a good 50 feet a second.
Yeah, and if he had a car, he could probably get him faster.
Yeah, probably. If his car is 0 to 60.
Or if he had like a radio yeah. flyer wagon with a.
Yeah,
know,
right
bunch
October,
of snacks.
Right? Is that the movie about the wagon?
No, no, I was thinking about open
No, right
open
October
season.
Is the rocket.
No, that's open a submarine.
Season. Open season.
Mm-hmm.
Open season? You guys ever seen fucking Iron Man?
Oh, yeah, yeah, the animated show. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That was right. That was right when, that was like the last
no,
animated
no, no,
movie
no, no.
I saw.
Over the Hedge. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
With Martin Lawrence.
No, no, open season. Yeah, was
Martin Lawrence.
No, it's like where there's this whole suburb community
yeah,
right outside
it, yeah.
of their forest. Yeah,
yeah, over the hedge.
And it happens while they're in hibernation.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to see no fucking bear and just live and
yeah.
And whew.
You definitely wouldn't take a picture instinctually.
Well, people who aren't around
or play dead.
It
who
all
does
the time. They think it's cool. Like this, they think the bear is like the fucking cartoon.
They think it's
no,
Winnie the
bear
Pooh.
Will fucking maul
Come
you.
Come over here, piglet.
You know?
This ain't the Jungle Book. I will
yeah.
maul your ass.
Yeah, this bear will eat your face.
Do you have any honey, piglet?
Like, but like I used to work at a high finance restaurant, right? So certain times during the year,
up on the crest.
Yeah, up on the crest.
Oh shit, I ate there a couple times when I was a kid.
Bears. To come up and like fucking go through the trash.
Yep.
Like we'll go outside to pull the trash. I'm like, well, fuck that.
Black
trash
bears or brown bears?
I'm not sure. Well, it was just
race
a thing. Fucking bear. It was the bear.
Why do we gotta be racial? No, nah, man. All bears. I'm terrified of fucking black, brown.
Yeah, yeah. Be
brown bears,
bears
are usually
deers.
More. Well, see, because black bears usually just eat fruit. Like they'll eat berries and okay. like just sort of vegetation and stuff. Yeah. They're mostly vegetarians, but they'll sometimes go into carnivore mode if there's not enough food around.
Oh, yeah.
Which was the case for these kids. They started taking pictures. There were 6 pictures taken as the bear got closer and closer, and one of the kids got killed who was taking the pictures.
Did the bear eat him, too?
I don't think it ate him. It definitely... Well, because bears have that thing where if they're going to eat, or if they're going to attack, they're going to do both at the same time.
Yeah.
So, yes, the bear was eating him alive.
Whoa! Taking a selfie with the phone, with the iPhone.
Check out my intestines in this bear's mouth, brah.
Yeah, man.
That's something that would happen to Dan Raskin while he was blackout drunk, and then he'd be like, so last week, guys, I got eaten by a bear.
Like, and, sure. You know, he kind of looked like you because you look kind of fat with a mustache and hairy. He just starts involving somebody in the crowd.
So, Alan.
What up?
I like your Andrew Dice Clay impression, man.
You like dice?
Oh God!
Have you ever watched a movie called The Adventures of Ford Fairlane, Rock and Roll Detective?
Ford Fairlane.
No.
You seen it?
Oh yeah, that was one of my favorite movies when I was a kid.
It's still one of my.
So
favorite
what,
movies.
Mary? You're just gonna be contrary?
You
turn that
gotta
push
watch
fucking Harry.
You gotta watch this movie, Alan. You will have a whole new respect for this guy.
Like, no, I have respect for Dice. Dice is the shit. I understand that he's a good actor.
But this movie is like one of the best movies of all time.
Is it like rock and roll detective? Is it on the caliber of like the acting he did before one of his stand-up specials where he had his girlfriend at his mom's house and she was complaining that he was all broke?
Much better. He's like,
you can't even give me a ring. I don't need to give you a ring. I have my own career going for me.
Much better than that. So like, just to set it up, he's a detective for like rock and roll, you know, people out in Hollywood, right? And he's always fucking
bitching. I investigate why Motley Crue fell out of the public eye so quickly.
Too, right? Yeah. I think that group was modeled after Motley Crue anyway. But the thing was, like, so he's always fucking bitches. And after he fucks bitches, he makes them clean his house.
Well, he has a system. He's Dice.
He did have a system because it's like he fucks these two bitches and they're waking up like, we just wanted to be held. He's like, do my dishes. You
know? Hey, bitch, do my dishes.
Do my dishes.
You see the crusty eggs from the scrambled eggs that you burned earlier? Yeah, clean it up. Do you remember?
So he's falling off a building, right? He's falling off the RCA Records building. Or
I'm
something.
Falling.
And it's like three other
will
people.
Will I roll
falling.
A six or a three?
No, he's even cooler than that. Because
he's Dice.
Right? So all these people are falling. They're like, ah! And the next person's like, ah! And Andrew Dice Clay's falling. He's like, my hair.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I need to get it right if I'm going to see the angels.
What's the shit called again? I've never seen this.
You've never seen
The Adventures of Ford Fairlane, yes.
Ford Fairlane.
Oh, man, Luis, you would love that movie.
Yeah, I'm going to check that joint out,
fucking hilarious, man.
No doubt.
Did you ever see The Day the Laughter Died?
Mm-mm.
It's did you ever see that, Alan?
I didn't know Chris Forte had a documentary.
No. Oh. He was wearing a laughter t-shirt the other night. No, it's actually
funny.
This Dice special, and he totally bombs, dude. Mm. Like for most
Wait,
of
which
his
one life. Was that? Was that the one where he was in the round? Like where he had the crowd all around him and
I didn't see, I heard he just
had
heard
his,
it.
He had his hair up. Oh. Am I the bad guy? That one?
I'm
trying to.
Yeah, it's that I've one seen with that random line that you're misquoting. You're right.
So he just eats.
No,
it.
I don't. It could be. Yeah, I don't know. He doesn't do well. Right. But
I think
it's
I know
still,
which one.
Yeah,
you're
it
about.
Still takes a lot of like. It's an interesting thing to listen to. I would definitely recommend.
Yeah, I think.
I think
I know which one you're talking about, and that's where he had his hair kind of puffed out, and he had a headband around it, kind of keeping it back, and he was wearing a shirt with cutoffs, so it was like sleeveless. He looked like a boxer in training, and there was this big intro at the beginning.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
Like, I'm
right.
Training for the special. I'm the comedy king.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah. I assume it was that one. Because yeah. I've watched a few of his specials, and that's the one that I didn't like so much.
Because he would kind of bomb throughout.
Yeah, and then
he was
right
mean
at the
to
end,
the audience.
Right at the end, he had this whole, like, sum up of his entire career, kind of, where he starts going off on this Scarface speech.
Does he cry?
No, he doesn't cry.
Okay, he used to.
Hear that? I heard Tom pissing. Anyways.
Is it turning you on?
No.
Oh, well, it is me. Anyway.
He's probably pissing with a boner. Another callback.
Probably.
But, yeah, that was the one where he had, like, this whole sum up where he was like, so you want to call me the bad guy because MTV want to ban me? Like, kind of thing. And he was, yeah, it was... like a very Scarface-style preaching speech. The end of the special was not funny at all, but it got his fans like, yeah, Dice!
No, they were like just pulling for him at that point.
Yeah.
Were you a fan of Dice, Luis? Kind of was a one-trick pony, but...
Yeah, I mean, I liked it while it was hot. Like, I thought it was funny. You know, yeah. I remember seeing the special where he had the jacket with the studs.
Yeah. Three blind mice.
Right.
Where the fuck they going?
Hickory dickory duck, hey!
This broad was sucking my cock.
Right.
The clock struck two, I dripped my goo, I dropped the bitch on the next block.
Right.
I made it family-friendly when I did that one last night.
Oh, did you?
I changed it from drop the bitch on the next block to dropped her on the next block.
Oh, okay, I'm sure that made it better.
It still works.
It's one of them things, man. Like you know, it's like okay, that was funny. Now what else you got? Now,
yeah. Exactly. What else? It's like Derek Sloan's one-liners. Hmm. Do monsters drink energy drinks called humans?
Right.
Do accounts drink energy drinks called monsters? Right. Okay,
my man. Yeah, man. I mean, everybody. We want it quick. We want it now, and then we want something brand new.
Yeah,
that's how we are. I mean,
it's a short attention
very
span thing.
Short.
That's why. I kind of like doing the long form conversation on this where people actually, the people who do listen are, for the most part, listening to large chunks of it.
Wow.
Where it's not just 7 seconds, 20 seconds, a 30-second video.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we watch these short videos and turn them into 5-10 minutes worth of stuff. It's fun.
Yep.
Yeah. We're just planting thoughts in your head of how you should think of when you watch certain videos. Old lady getting swung around, you should think it's funny.
Old lady getting swung around. Now that
we put
was,
that on our
that's
website.
That's a good one. I've seen that one.
Did you see
yeah,
that one?
The,
she's
the
like in
Russian,
a robe.
Yeah. Yeah, big overcat. And then
she's in some serious G's, man. That old chick was getting serious G's.
They drop her, she runs away like E.T., and then they run back and pick her up again.
Hit her with some more spins.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. They was hitting her with the Zangief spin.
Yeah.
Zangiefter.
Tiger uppercut.
One of the things that I wanted to get to also was this story about Scott Stapp.
Oh.
Because he was pretty big at one time.
Then we'll move on to Kill Bosby.
Oh, yeah, Kill Bosby, yeah. Scott Stapp. You guys remember Scott Stapp from Creed?
I've been through everything.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. With arms wide open.
What about,
yeah,
what about him? What's going on with this guy?
T.I. saved his life.
Well,
T.I. saved his life?
Wait, who is this?
Yes.
Let me hear, get
yes.
out of here.
Okay, here
wait,
we go.
Go.
I thought it was Scott Stoud.
No, it's Scott Stapp.
I've been through everything.
There you go. Like a Stapp on.
Been through everything.
Let's see here. So, Scott Stapp, lead singer of Creed, is homeless, without money, and without money to feed himself.
No way. Sold 20 million albums.
No way.
That's according to a video apparently shot using a borrowed phone he just posted to Facebook. It sounds awful, and not just because he incessantly smacks his lips.
Wait, who?
Scott Stapp.
I've been through everything.
There we go.
That guy.
And
the guy who sounds remarkably similar to Eddie Vedder.
We watched the video, and he did smack his lips. Actually, he smacks them. Yeah,
he does a lot of that. He's like sitting there talking, like, I know you guys think there's a lot going on with me, and I know that it's not going to be that easy for me and for you as well. And it was constant. Yeah, play the audio.
Let me borrow
put it up
a
to the mic. Put it up to the mic.
Pretty vicious attack. I still haven't figured out the reasons why, except that about 8 weeks ago, I began an audit of not only my record company, but my personal
finances. So much clicking.
During the course of that audit, a lot of things were uncovered.
That
a lot of money
shit.
Was stolen from me, or what royalties
is he
not paid.
Is he a fish out of water?
And that's when
struggling for air.
All hell began to break loose.
Goodness.
All of a sudden, the IRS has frozen my bank accounts.
Meaning he didn't pay
times.
His bills.
Basically.
Yeah, keep your shit in your mattress.
Me completely penniless.
What?
That was me.
I don't even understand that. Why all this is happening at the same time. When I called to find out why, they said, oh, we had an address mix up. It was a clerical error. So
bullshit.
The IRS ain't playing with their money.
Hell no, they don't mess up.
Right now, I'm looking for an honest,
blowjob,
good attorney.
I should contact this dude and just like fake it.
I'm a collection officer.
Yeah, I've been doing it for 13
by the
years.
Of God,
I've
because there's been a couple weeks where I had to sleep in my truck.
Jeez.
I've been through everything.
I had no money, not even for gas or food.
I've been through everything.
Now this is Scott Stapp. If you remember how big Creed was.
Wait, who?
Huge.
Scott Stapp.
Yeah. Huge. I know about him.
Yeah, he was and
I bought their album.
Really?
I wouldn't go that far. You're lying, Black Mike.
I swear to God.
Black Mike's black people, so he's joking.
I bought it.
We don't
say he's lying.
I'm sorry, but I don't know one black Creed fan. I cannot say that.
Fair enough.
Sorry.
I don't know one either.
I cannot say I do.
What was the one song?
Well, that's because I don't know one Creed fan.
Dude.
Okay. So let's a couple of things. He says the IRS has frozen his bank accounts and that he's completely penniless, that his label, Wind Up Records, is responsible for royalties not paid. And then there's an identity thief who he accuses of obtaining his passwords and draining his accounts. So it's It does sound like one of those things where it's like, no, it's a conspiracy, totally.
It's a conspiracy.
What is that, Jesse?
They used thermite paint on his bank account to make it
That's
bleed
right
white through.
Just like 9/11, right?
Yes.
Okay, so...
No, not like 9/11. You weren't there. You weren't the SEAL.
No, I wasn't. But then, so it's like all these different reasons that he has for being broke or these hardships. But I was reading this article, and it actually talks about the... how he's not the smartest guy. I think we all could have assumed
a
that.
Little bit.
But there's a blowjob video that almost made its way to the internet of him and Kid Rock not blowing each other. I know that would be like the first thing you would think and hope
it's
for, because you'd be like,
situation.
Oh, please just let Kid Rock get caught with a dick in his mouth.
Wax.
You mean Bob Rock?
Wax
Bob Rock.
So anyway, that almost got out, and apparently Kid Rock wasn't too pleased with him. But he did try to kill himself by jumping off of a roof.
Miami.
And yes, and T.I. really did save him, actually.
T.I. saved – that's the second person. T.I. saved someone else, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
That girl from the video.
Stapp explained that he checked into the penthouse of Miami Delano Hotel during a drug binge. After days of being awake, phantom voices in a hotel's white walls prompted visions of being trapped in an asylum.
That's schizophrenia.
And Stapp jumped over his balcony, falling 40 feet. He fractured his skull.
1402, room 1402.
Fractured his skull.
He fractured his skull, broke his hip and nose and couldn't move. Then in comes T.I. I laid out there for 2.5 hours and my guardian angel showed up. Rapper T.I. He immediately took care of the situation and saved my life.
When you told me the story, I thought he like landed on T.I. because you said he jumped out of a
window in the back.
You were saying that like he jumped out of a window and T.I. saved him. I was like, what, did he catch him?
Goodness, man.
Because T.I. seems like the kind of person with his muscles to be able to like actually catch somebody
man,
from a 40-foot ball.
T.I. is like 4'11".
I was going to say, T.I.'s a little guy.
He's like 4'11".
T.I.'s a little guy.
But he's built. He's built.
He's a little cut, more cut now. When he first came out, he was
like, I was bigger than him.
Right, I was like,
I would take his lunch money.
Yeah, man.
Someone brought up the...
I would take his auto-tune pattern.
Someone brought up the fact that that's not the first time that T.I. has actually saved someone's life.
Yeah.
And you're right, because in 2010, on the way to a music video shoot, T.I. stopped talked a man out of jumping off of a 22-story building.
Yeah. Only if it was 30.
Why is that?
Well... He probably would have died. He wouldn't have heard T.I. yelling at him from the ground.
There you go. That's a good one.
Still do that.
Damn it, Mike. It's like you know.
He pushed him.
He pushed him.
Oh, and then this is
I know that because I wasn't there.
What else is going on with the
This is my favorite
defense.
Story, too, out of the whole thing, is in Florida. Let's see here. I think this was in 2000. It was in the mid-2000s on July 29th in Gainesville. Some people had the number of Scott Stapp. He had given it to a girl at an airport as she was leaving. She was going to Amsterdam, so... she gave the number to her friend and was like, hey, maybe you can use it sometime, blah, blah, blah.
Suck
the story
his balls. Use the number sometime.
It sounds kind of fishy, but it sounds
Don't
like
suck
it.
Suck his balls, get us paid.
I mean, Vice is quoting it, and I've heard about this story before. I just never saw the actual specific account. So apparently they start texting Stapp. He was in town. He was nearby. And they convince him to go to a Denny's 2 hours away in Gainesville.
2 hour drive to go get some pussy.
Yeah, and
at a Denny's.
You're famous.
Best case scenario, you
Scott
still
Stapp.
Best case scenario, you're getting pancakes and some eggs and bacon at 3 a.m. You have to pay for your date's food that you drove 200 miles to go see.
That's the case. Being famous ain't all it's cracked up to be. If I gotta drive 2 hours to get some pussy.
Jeez.
No, that's Christian famous. It's different.
Okay.
Very different.
Big difference.
They go to family-friendly places. They don't go to bars.
So on that on a Friday night, he flew into Orlando and gave that girl a call. The girl, wanting to make him look like a douche, played along, and she texted him, "You should drive up to Gainesville tonight to see me." Because he was in a probably in a bad place. Rumors were going around that he had just gotten fired, but he was also not doing that well, like professionally. Like Creed was, they were one of those bands that they blow up really quick, yeah, and then there's nowhere else to go but down. You know,
like Apollo Creed.
Yeah, there's going to be a backlash of some sort. So anyway,
ain't gonna be no rematch.
Ain't gonna be no rematch.
My bad. Go.
Have you seen? By the way, I have to bring this up. I won't let you know how this happened. Well, actually, I should. I played basketball with Royal Wood on numerous occasions.
Is he any good?
He has what I call Apollo Creed breasts. He has, if you remember Apollo Creed's breasts from Rocky IV, probably some of the most perfect pectoral muscles in the history.
Was that the Russian?
Mm-hmm. No, he's right. Apollo Creed, his buddy. And anyway, that's what Royal's chest looks like. So I'm just calling him out
pretty
on
cut.
That, looking like that.
Do my push-ups.
Got the taco meat.
Little bit.
So anyway, Mr. Creed walks into the Denny's, and that girl stops answering her phone. But she has one of her friends who is wearing a cast run up to him and like scream, you know, really loud, "Oh my God, you're Scott Stapp from Creed."
I've been through everything.
There you go.
It's me.
And so like the security guard almost kicks him out because it was like
too
making because it was making a
scene.
Commotion.
But what time of the night was this at?
This
or was
it
in the middle of the day?
Let's see here. No,
this was
at
the morning,
night.
Right? 3 a.m. Denny's.
3 a.m.
It was about 1 or
1 to
6 in the morning, cops at my door.
Let's see here. So he's walking around and people are recognizing him. They note that he's only 5'6" here. No, sorry about that, Mike. It's not a big deal.
I tell you, I'm 5'7".
But he's not a big guy. Why would it be a big deal?
But no, it's worse because when you're like a huge rock star like that, people are probably going to expect a lot more than if you're like Mr. Funny. Or if we're comics. We're supposed to be a little bit funny looking. Right. You know,
you mean just dysfunctional.
Yeah, or
but
whatever.
Being famous like that, you probably think he's like 6'7".
Exactly.
No, you would think he's like walking into the Denny's praying as soon as he gets in there, like, "Oh, I have to make sure my food is going to be blessed.
Put my pancakes down with the arms wide open."
What drug exactly? What problem did he have with coke, meth? What's going on with
It was cocaine and alcohol.
Coke and alcohol?
So,
yeah, you would have to do cocaine to be into singing those songs.
It can't be crack.
My arms wide open.
People do crack, honestly.
Really?
I met one guy. He told me the reason why he did crack.
Crack is.
Well, he said he tried crack and he told himself, "Why the fuck was I wasting my time with weed all these years?" He said that's how good crack is.
Yeah, because it's not the same high. You know, you want to come down. You want to chill.
Yeah, you don't want to.
You can't chill on crack.
You can't chill on meth either.
If you want to call sleeping and eating chilling,
I don't want to be cleaning up while I'm high.
Right.
You know.
Well, you don't want to fuck. You know, you don't want to be super spun out. Like I know some people.
Clean
that actually
that
smoke
strong?
Meth and
is Mr. Clean that strong? If you smoke it, it makes you what a clean.
It also makes you shave your head.
Right. And get a gay ass earring.
Gay ass earring. Like that's the least of your worries if you're smoking crack is if you get a gay ass earring. Not if you're cleaning or shaving your head. You got a gay ass earring.
What's with the earrings? Are you smoking drugs?
Here's where I beg to differ because Mr. Clean was always wearing fucking a pure white fucking
robe.
Get up.
Oh.
And you know a gay man would never be caught in that. Just pure
especially
white,
not after
not
Labor Day.
Toe
Thank
t-shirt.
You.
Yeah. It should be seasonal. So anyway, that's Scott Stapp. If you guys want to donate to Scott Stapp, just go online and look up douchebag, and I'm sure they will have some sort of.
If Kevin Kennedy doesn't show up,
oh yeah, look up douchebag. Kevin Kennedy will show up. Scroll down a couple screens, and then you'll see Scott Stapp. I know it's
you guys
I know,
are going to bring up Bill Cosby.
So you guys don't have a
actually,
Bill Cosby another day.
I think Bill Cosby raped me. Fuck this.
He raped
I'm getting
you.
In. I'm getting. I gotta get me some paper. He raped me. He raped the shit out of me. It was 1989.
Bill touched me.
They were on the Cosby Show tour, and
it's horrible.
He touched my knee. I need money.
Can you tell us anything about?
Was it your low knee or your high knee?
It was my knee. It was my knee. He walked past and brushed my knee.
See, no, that was a butt
money.
Joke.
Yeah, he took my anus. I need money. Everyone, so, apparently he raped every bitch in Hollywood.
Yeah.
How was this? How has this gone undercover for so long?
Jesse the Body.
He didn't pay enough.
It was all conspiracies to keep it out of the news.
You know,
what
these girls
should
need to step forward. You know, Bill Cosby should be asking for a receipt from these bitches if they're going to step forward now. I gave you the money to shut the fuck up.
Well,
you
in fact,
step forward, I need my money back.
Yeah. And well, that one guy came out. There was a guy that came out that said he was like the fucking fixer for Cosby back in the 80s. I didn't read too much of the story in depth, but they did have like proof of like money orders that he had, right? Like copies.
He took pictures of it.
Money orders are the shadiest way to pay any bill.
Oh yeah,
exactly. Right.
Like, at least the cashier's check. There's like a $2.50 fee from your bank.
The money should be under the roofie glass.
I never.
The money should be the roofie glass.
Yeah, right. Oh man.
Yeah.
But did you guys? But did you guys know Jesse Ventura just did an interview with Bill Cosby?
No way.
Yeah, he did.
The Body?
He was going to get to the bottom of the conspiracy.
The only problem is I only got like the preview mode because he hasn't released the rest of it yet.
Oh, he's trying to say it's a conspiracy?
So he's teasing it.
Well, he's not exactly asking him about rape. But he kind of treats the questions like he is being asked about rape. It's really weird. So let's watch this real quick. And yeah. All the way through without any interruption.
Yeah.
All right.
He's one of America's most popular voices out there. And he recently launched VoicesOfLiberty.com, a news and views video site to which I contribute. Please welcome our old friend back,
Bill Cosby.
Let's get right to the nitty gritty. So I can make the statement Obama came out and said it's a political stunt. You'd agree with that?
No, we don't answer that. There's no response.
Okay, now, speaking of political stunts, do you think anyone's taking Sarah Palin's impeachment plans seriously?
There is no comment about that. And I'll tell you why. I think you were told.
Hey, don't put fucking words in my mouth.
I think you were told. I don't want to compromise your integrity.
Well, we'll just fly with that. What the hell? My government told me that, so.
But I don't talk about it.
Let's talk about inflation. You think we're on the brink of massive inflation. Please explain that to me.
Thank you.
Now, can I get something from you?
What's that?
That none of that will be shown. I know I didn't say anything, but I'm asking your integrity that since I didn't want to say anything, but I did answer you in terms of I don't want to say anything of what value will it have.
Come back tomorrow at 3 p.m. Eastern for the conclusion to my interview with
Bill Cosby.
Until then, keep the conversation going online, and as always, stay vigilant.
And stay dressed like a psychedelic pirate.
Oh, good.
Bill.
Yeah.
Don't tell Camille. She's sitting right next to me.
Don't tell Camille.
I feel bad for her, man.
I don't.
She's keeping a strong front, this brave smile.
Stand by your man.
Camille's a ride or die bitch, for real. I mean, I give her that, man. You know, she knows where the money's at. At this point, man, you know what?
If I'm this old and I'm Bill Cosby, I done achieved all I did.
Like, fuck it, I did it. Yeah,
exactly.
I did it.
Exactly.
What the fuck y'all going to do to me?
I would give details on every bitch that came out. Yeah, man, suck my dick.
Yeah.
Apparently she's oblivious to fucking roofies and
go out with a bang, bro.
Yeah.
Go out with a bang. Yeah. You killed him all this time. Just fucking I did it. I fucked up.
I would line up pictures.
Whatever.
I would line up pictures like anal, man. oral, anal, oral. You know what I mean?
Trophies.
Yeah, trophies.
No,
yeah.
Real shit though.
And the one that's the big mural over the fireplace is shoved the strap of the little tie off spot of my robe into herself.
Yeah, that's the big one. This is my big achievement.
And I'll be honest about it.
I mean,
like,
I shoved it into her
bitches,
since she was asleep.
This is my baby.
I asked them first. They didn't want to have sex with Cliff Huxtable.
So, Mike, are you feeling a little lightheaded because you opened up a normal beer?
I did.
You feeling a little normal there? Or you feeling a little lightheaded?
What?
Was that that special pudding?
Man, you got me scared to drive.
Fuck on. Yeah, no, man. If I had roofies, I wouldn't waste them on you. God. All I did is switch out your Altoids with roofies.
I remember this, this one chick, right? I was in the military. I got to tell a story real quick.
All
right. So I'm in the military, right? All we did was drink. This chick was passed out, like, on the steps. Just laid out on the steps, right? And all is like five of us there. We're just looking at her like, yo, we should caveman this bitch. Mm. Just grab her by the ankles and drag her down
skull
the
skull fuck her. Oh, boom, wait, what? Boom,
boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom. And take her to each person's room. Fuck the shit out of her. Take her back upstairs. Boom, 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 you know, by the ankles and shit. I think some guy actually did that. I got kicked
Bill Cosby
out.
Came and got her later.
Yeah, he took care of him, yeah. He didn't pay her off.
Side note, Bill Cosby was actually in town during this time.
He, really?
When Laughs was up on Eubank or on Eubank and Wantabo back in the day. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that was
before
way
it hit
back.
The San Mateo location.
I never got
to. You never went out when it was on Wantabo? Yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't old enough to get in.
I went there one time.
I was just a boy. I wasn't allowed.
I wish we were friends then.
Was Russ still
there? Oh, yay.
Real quick, can we do that? You out?
Whoa, we're literally about to finish.
We're gonna wrap her up.
Yeah. Okay. So anyway,
I don't wrap
like
her
any
up,
of us know what
kids.
That's about.
So anyway, yeah, that was the show, guys. Sorry to bring it to an abrupt end, but I think we covered everything.
With some Kill Bosby. Yeah. And what was Kill his name? Bosby. Scott Stoud.
Scott Stapp.
I've been through everything, but
even left some stuff out. So
buy Creed's album. Get this guy some money.
We'll cover it on Saturday when we have a little bit more of a long form.
That's right.
Isn't it weird that we differentiate an hour 30 and an hour 20 as sort of short form and long form?
No,
I want to talk Saturday when?
Saturday at 2:45.
I want to talk. I know I got a show that day with the.
Kevin Kennedy.
I didn't know how he wasn't very well received around, so we'll talk about that. I want to hear.
Okay, let's do that.
We're in open form. We've
absolutely.
Talked to Kevin Kennedy with
in fact,
some problems.
Yeah, we'll queue up some shows.
No doubt.
So he called into the show one time.
We called him.
Oh,
yeah.
That was, yes.
But that was because John and him were having a battle on Facebook that day.
Yeah.
By that point, they had already pretty much resolved it, and John was like, we're still going to call you for the podcast. And then when we did that, Kevin had pretty much nothing to say.
Yeah.
But the first time we called him, I hung up on him. Yeah. He was like, he was promoting his show. He's like, tonight we have the Headliners comedy show at Broken Bottle. And John's like, oh yeah, what's the deal with that? He goes, it's free. And you hear boop. Then he started texting me like, hey, I guess we lost the connection. Like, yeah, I know. The phones suck. I
guess we did.
Yeah, I guess we did.
All right. So we'll, yeah. Hey, thanks to everybody who listened. Thanks to Black Mike. Black Mike, where are you at next?
Nowhere.
Nowhere
Nexus.
For Nexus, right on.
And here.
Oh, we might see you at Back Alley maybe sometime.
Next week is my good week, so I can
buddy.
Out next week, yeah.
Luis, you're doing a show Saturday.
I will actually be doing a show with Mr. Kevin Kennedy and Sam.
Okay, cool.
Broke the bottle.
Check it out.
Yeah, and if you want to come back on Saturday, we can run down a few histories
out,
with you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Alan, he will be doing the show. He'll be putting out new stuff.
I'll be putting up the Andrew Harms Show on potentialproblems.com on our new website.
New website.
New website that we have.
We will be hosting other podcasts.
Yes, it is a network officially. Oh, God. It is officially a network.
It is.
Yes.
All right. So thanks for listening, guys. Thanks to everybody. You guys are awesome. Have a good night. Bye-bye.
We can't really do it on camera.